the, oh, by the way, I find compelling, you are satisfied. And the big thing I want from you, Mr. Ham, is can you come up with something that you can predict? Do you have a creation model that predicts something that will happen in nature?
And that's time.
This position would make a few predictions. The Bible says clearly, in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth and all that in them is. Everything created in 6 days. Now, based on that prediction, based on that premise, we can make a few predictions, which is what science is supposed to do. A scientific theory is supposed to allow you to make predictions. I predict, based on the Bible teaching, that the universe will show evidence of order and design all over the place, okay? I predict that we'll find thousands of symbiotic relationships in nature, animals that require certain plants and plants that require certain animals, and it works just fine because they were all created within a few days of each other. Not a problem at all for the creationist viewpoint. I predict that there will be limits to the variations that life forms are able to produce. The Bible says they will bring forth after their kind, and that's what we've observed. 6,000 years of human history shows us dogs produce dogs. Every time. Might be a big dog or a little dog, it might have curly hair or straight hair, but it's going to be a dog, guaranteed, okay? Farmers actually count on that. I mean, when they plant corn, they expect to get corn. And so far, it has happened. So certainly there are variations, but there are definite limits to the variations, and this is where the major difference comes between the creationist and the evolutionist. I predict that there are not only limits to the variation, I predict that there will be actually a purpose to life because we were designed by a creator for a purpose. That's a prediction based on the Bible view. I predict there will be non-material things like love, sense of justice, mercy, innate knowledge of right and wrong, a conscience, an absolute truth. Those things are not possible with the evolution theory. They are predicted based on the creation theory. Somebody designed this for a reason. I predict that there will be a way to find the will of the creator, such as messengers speaking for him, or maybe even a book telling us why he did it and how he did it. Mm-hmm. I predict there will be an afterlife where we will face the creator to give an accounting. Okay? The Bible dates, if you add them up in Scripture, comes to about 6,000 years ago for the creation, not millions. There's a large difference between 6,000 and 20 billion. Congress doesn't seem to understand that, but there is a big difference, okay? Now, based on the Bible teaching that the earth was originally created where people lived to be 900 years old, I predict we will find lots of legends about a golden age and a creation event. This seems to be kind of universal throughout history. Most people believe there was a creation, and most people believe there was a time when man used to live to be nearly 1,000. The Greeks talked about it, the Babylonians talked about it, the Sumerians. Everybody talked about this golden age. Why? Well, that's predicted based on the creation viewpoint, okay? I predict there will be skeletons found of people showing signs of great age, because they were living to be much older, you know, before things happen. And as you grow, especially the brow ridge of your head never stops growing. The constant pull on the back of your head, the occipital bun, based on just the muscles from holding your head forward, is going to elongate the head over 200 or 300 or 400 years. People would look exactly like the Neanderthals look. Brain 13% bigger than ours, few strange things about their head, but 100% human in every respect. I predict that there will be biological problems with modern man, such as wisdom teeth, because we're not as big as we used to be. And we're developing probably faster. People are maturing faster. They're only living to be in 80 or 90 instead of living to be 900. And wisdom teeth are a problem today, not because of evolution, but because we're actually genetically inferior to the original model, Adam and Eve, okay? I predict that there'll be a universal longing for things to be restored to the Garden of Eden conditions. That's what everybody seems to want, okay? Now,
one of the things I was doing was I was making predictions. I made some predictions. There's a whole list of predictions. And I was saying, if the Bible's right, and we're all saying it's about Adam and Eve, there's one race. And I went through and talked about that. If the Bible's right and God made kinds, I went through and talked about that.
Mr. Ham, a new question. This is a simple question, I suppose, but one that actually is fairly profound for all of us in our lives. What, if anything, would ever change your mind? Time, Mr. Nye?
We would just need one piece of evidence. We would need the fossil that swam from one layer to another. We would need evidence that the universe is not expanding. We would need evidence that the stars appear to be far away, but they're not. We would need evidence that rock layers can somehow form in just 4,000 years instead of the extraordinary amount.
That pyroclastic flow is right there, 25 feet in thickness. That formed on June 12, 1980, by a three-hour eruption, where a glowing avalanche of particles came off the summit. And it deposited a layered or laminated deposit. It was very interesting. Here you see the nine-hour eruption on May 18. You see the June 12th deposit, and then you see the March 19, 1982 mudflow deposit. Each layer at Mount St. Helens has a date.
We need evidence that somehow you can reset atomic clocks and keep neutrons from becoming protons. You bring on any of those things, and you would change me immediately.